हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द फर्स्ट सेशन ऑफ द पाइल फाउंडेशन. अकॉर्डिंग टू द एज यू नो अकॉर्डिंग टू रेज़ागी फाउंडेशंस आर क्लासिफाइड इन टू वेज, शैलो एंड डीप. इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द रेशियो डीएफ बाय बी. इफ डीएफ बाय बी इज लेस देन और इक्वल टू वन, देन यूजुअली इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ शैलो फाउंडेशन, अदरवाइज इट इज डीप फाउंडेशन. नाउ इन द डीप फाउंडेशन देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ फाउंडेशन, that is pile, pier and the caisson. Now when the soil at or near a ground surface is not capable to support a structure, usually a deep foundations are required to transfer the loads to the deeper strata. The most common types of deep foundation, as said, piles, piers and the caissons. Basically the pile is the slender structural member made up of steel, concrete or wood. Then the pile is either driven into the soil or formed in situ by excavating a borehole and then filling it with the green concrete. The pier is installed in the dry area by excavating a cylindrical hole of a large diameter to the desired depth and then backfilling it with the concrete. Usually a cast in situ pile greater than the 0.6 meter diameter is referred in general term as a pier. Then the necessity of a pile foundation. When a strata just below is a ground is highly compressible and the weak, then usually when the plan of structure is irregular relative to its outline and the load distribution, many times there is a unequal load distribution on the in the plan. Then when you want to transfer the load of a heavy load to the deep strata, to drip water to the firm stratum, then usually the pile foundation is required. Then to resist the horizontal forces in the case of particularly the earth retaining structures or tower buildings, the piles are required. Then many times the conditions are washout, erosion or scoring type of a condition, is such as in the case of bridge of a foundation of a bridge. Then in that case a pile foundation is required. For the foundations of transmission towers as well as the offshore platform which are subjected to the uplift, the anchor type of piles are required. Then in particularly the expansive soil which is having swelling and shrinkage like a black cotton soil, the soil piles are used to transfer the load to the deeper strata. Then in the case of coalescible soil, the piles are used to transfer the load beyond the zone of possible moisture zone. In all these cases, the pile foundation is required. Then, we'll discuss the classification, how piles are classified. The piles are classified according to the five criteria. First criteria is according to the material use. Depending on the material use, the piles are classified in the four ways. When a steel is used, then it is called as a steel piles. While designing a steel pile, thickness is considered or thickness is designed by considering the corrosion effect. Then the steel pile is usually in the form of a pipes, either solid or hollow, or sometimes it is in the terms of S sections. Necessarily the steel piles are the driven piles, which is driven with the help of a hammer. Then before driving, the epoxy coating is applied to the external surface of a pile to considering the corrosion effect. Then the widely used material is the concrete one, and which is we refer as a concrete piles. In the case of concrete piles, the concrete piles may be of two types again. It may be precast or it may be the cast in situ. Precast means which are casted into the factory. Then it is lightly reinforced to handle the transportation and erection stresses. Sometimes these precast piles are also pre-stressed one. Then cast in situ means the borehole is excavated and then is refilled with the green concrete. Sometimes a casing is used, and then if casing is kept there, then it is called as a case cast in situ board pile, or if it is removed, then it is uncased cast in situ pile. Then sometimes the timber piles are used below the groundwater table, because this timber pile gives a better performance when driven below the groundwater table. Usually the timber pile is having a steel shoe at the bottom, and then before driving this pile, the preservative in the form of a creosote oil is applied to the timber pile, and then many times the composite material is used, composite pile is used, in which on the top there is a concrete, and at the bottom, which that means which portion which goes below the groundwater table, consists of either steel or the timber. As we have seen, the steel and the timber gives a better performance when they are laid below the groundwater table. This is the first criteria. Then the second criteria on the basis of which the piles are classified is the mode of transfer of a load. When the load carrying capacity, or when the load is derived by the point resistance, when it is transferred to the firm strata below the tip or a bottom, then usually it is called as an end bearing pile. In that case, the load carrying capacity QA is equal to QP, that is the point resistance. Then the second type of pile, when it does not reaches to the firm strata, when it floats into the soft strata, then it is called as a friction piles or a floating piles. In this case, the load carrying capacity or the resistance is derived by the skin resistance which occurs or in between the adjoining soil and the pile shaft. Then it is called as a floating pile. Then when the resistance is derived by the combined action of a skin friction and the end bearing, then it is called as a combined end bearing and friction piles. In that case, then the load bearing capacity is equal to the QP, summation of a QP plus QS, that is a point resistance, plus the skin resistance. Then the third criteria is the how the pile is installed. The pile, if pile is driven into the soil with the help of a hammer, then it is called as a driven pile. The steel piles, concrete piles, or even a timber piles can be driven into the soil. Then the second type is the cast in situ. And as I have said, in the case cast in situ driven, cast in situ bored. When casing is initially driven into the soil and then hole is made and then casing is kept there, then it is called as a cast in situ driven case pile. Or when the casing is not driven, directly the hole is drilled into the soil and then it is refilled with the concrete, then it is a cast in situ bored pile. Then sometimes a pile is screwed into the soil, like a screw in the we screw material into the timber. And the last type of pile is the jack one, where the force is applied to drive the pile into the soil. This is the third criteria on the basis of which piles are classified. The fourth criteria is the based on the use. The most of the times the piles are used as a load bearing structure, and therefore it is a load bearing member, therefore it is called as a load bearing piles. Sometimes when the we met with the loose soil, granular soil, then to increase the relative density of such loose to medium granular soil, a compaction piles are used. These piles are necessarily the driven piles. These are the driven with the help of a hammer into the loose soil, such that the soil adjoining to the pile get displaced and giving the better relative density. Then the third type is the tension pipes. Basically, we know the piles are the compression member, but in few cases, the piles are used to take the tension. When we want to anchor any structure which is subjected to the uplift, for example, you can take the example of a raft which is supported on the pile in the case of intake well, which is subjected to the uplift. Okay, then that raft or the base of the intake well is held with the these anchor piles or two tension piles. Then the sheet pile, it is nothing but it is one continuous wall which is driven into the soil to retain the soil or water. Then the fender piles, usually when you want to protect the waterfront structures near the seashore from the impact of ships, then the fender piles are used. We have seen the two examples, that is the first one is the octahedral which are kept on the seashore. Then second thing, if you have seen the deep stamba exactly behind, exactly in front of the main door of any temple, any old temples, then you'll find there is a huge tall structure which is having the projections in the case in the form of fenders on which we keep the dips during the festival. Those projections are act as a fender piles, and it will protect the entire temple or the main door of a temple from the disasters, or when the flood comes, then the velocity get damp near before entering into the temple, which will reduce the damage to the temple. Then the anchor piles. Now when sheet piles are installed, usually to anchor the sheet piles, the anchor piles are used. This is the fourth classification depending on the use. Then the last classification, that is the fifth criteria, is based on the displacement of a pile. The first one is the displacement piles, and second is the non-displacement piles. The displacement piles are maybe precast or a close in the form of a closed pipes, which is classified as a high displacement pile, or few piles are edge piles or I sections, which are referred as a low displacement pile. In both cases, it displaces the soil adjoining to it, causing the densification, and those piles are called as a displacement pile. Then the non-displacement piles, when we drill a hole and when we refill it with the concrete, which we called as a board pile, usually the board piles are a non-displacement pile, which will not cause the displacement of a adjoining material. This is all about the classification of the pile.